What's up, Black Scholars? Today we're gonna take a look at one of my favorite theological books, A Black Theology of Liberation by James H. Cone. Sit back, hold on to your seat, because some of what he has to say in the book will blow your mind. But go ahead and smash that like button and subscribe to the channel. Christian Theology. Christian theology is a theology of liberation. It is a rational study of the being of God in the world in light of the existential situation of an oppressed community, relating the forces of liberation to the essence of the gospel, which is Jesus Christ. This means that its sole reason for existence is to put into ordered speech the meaning of God's activity in the world, so that the community of the oppressed will recognize that its inner thrust for liberation is not only consistent with the gospel, but it's the gospel of Jesus Christ. There can be no Christian theology that is not identified unreservedly with those who have been humiliated and abused. In fact, theology ceases to be theology of the gospel when it fails to arise out of a community of the oppressed. Point 2, liberation and Black theology. American white theology has not been involved in the struggle of Black liberation. It has been basically a theology of the white oppressor, giving religious sanction to the genocide of the Amerindians and the enslavement of Africans. From the very beginning to the present day, American white theology thought has been patriotic, either by defining the theological task independently of Black suffering, the liberal Northern approach, or by defining Christianity as compatible with white racism, the conservative Southern approach. In both cases, theology becomes a servant of the state, and that can only mean death to Blacks. It is a little wonder that an increasing number of Black religionists are finding it difficult to be Black and to be identified with traditional theological thought forms. Point 3, and I title this Black Jesus. The task of Black theology, then, is to analyze the nature of the gospel of Jesus in light of the oppressed Blacks, so they will see the gospel as inseparable from their humiliated condition, and as bestowing on them the necessary power to break the chains of oppression. This means that it is a theology of and for the Black community, seeking to interpret the religious dimensions of the forces of liberation in that community. God is not colorblind. In a racist society, God is never colorblind. To say God is colorblind is analogous to saying God is blind to justice and injustice, to right and wrong, to good and evil. Either God is for Blacks in their fight for liberation from white oppression, or God is not. God cannot be both for us and for white oppressors at the same time. Whites are in no position whatsoever to question the legitimacy of Black theology. Questions like, do you think theology is Black, or what about others who suffer, are the products of mind incapable of Black thinking. It is not surprising that those who reject Blackness in theology are usually whites who do not question the blue-eyed white Christ. It is hard to believe that whites are worried about Black theology on account of its alleged annihilation of other sufferers. Oppressors are not genuinely concerned about any oppressed group. It would seem rather that white rejection of Black theology stems from a recognition of the revolutionary implication in its very name, a rejection of whiteness, an unwillingness to live under it, and an identification of whiteness with evil and Blackness with good. Point 5, sinful theology. The sin of American theology is that it has spoken without passion. It has failed miserably in relating its work to the oppressed in society by refusing to confront the structures of this nation with the evils of racism. When it has tried to speak for the poor, it has been so cool and calm in its analysis of human evil that it implicitly disclosed whose side it was on. Most of the time, American theology has simply remained silent, ignoring the condition of the victims of this racist society. How else can we explain the theological silence during the period of white lynching of black humanity in this nation? How else can we explain the inability of white religionists to deal relevantly with the new phenomenon of black consciousness? And how else can we explain the problem white seminaries are having as they seek to respond to radical black demands? There is really only one answer. American theology is a racist theology. It identifies theology as dispassionate analysts of the tradition, unrelated to the suffering of the oppressed. All right, family, I hope you enjoyed these 5 quick points from chapter 1 of James Cone's book, A Black Theology of Liberation. If you enjoyed this, go ahead and smash the like button and let me know in the comment section if you would like me to do additional reviews of James Cone's books. Again, everything that I talked about in this particular video only came from chapter 1. Like I always say, knowledge is power, but knowledge shared is power multiplied.